name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Will you give your child? What you ask of God's church for these things? You baptize us for the baptized. In doing so, you're accepting the responsibility of training them in the practice of the faith. By loving God and our neighbor, do you clearly understand what you are undertaking? Are you ready, godparents? Are you ready to help the parents of this child and their numerous Christian parents? Yes. Yeah. Jessica Kathleen, this ministry welcomes you with great joy. In its name I claim you for Christ our Savior by the sign of this cross. Now, please cross over the door and invite your parents to God's parents to do the same. Jessica, can I do that? What? By then, a reading from the Gospel according to Matthew, Jesus came forward and addressed the 11 disciples in these words, "Full authority has been given to me both in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptize them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teach them to carry out everything that I commanded you, and hold the line of you always until the end of the world." So we're following Jesus' command to say, And we record this as a second birthday for the youngsters. It's a birthday that's where our children of God, heirs of heaven, and so they become new persons, new Christians. We carefully record it. And this will always be these records we have to do. We're going to need to fill out the white column. The one record I give you is dated to me, but later on in the New Generation, you always have an updated record. My dear brothers and sisters, let us ask our Lord Jesus Christ to look lovingly on these children who are to be baptized, and their parents and godparents, and on all the baptized. By the mystery of your death and resurrection, bathe in so many life, give them new life to baptism, and welcome them into your holy church. Lord bless you. In baptism and confirmation, make them your faithful follower and a witness to your gospel. Lord, hear us. Lead them by a holy life and the joys of God's kingdom. Make the lives of their parents and godparents examples of faith and inspire them to honor. Keep their families always in your love. Renew the grace of our baptism in each one of us. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us. St. John the Baptist, pray for us. St. Joseph, pray for us. St. Peter and St. Paul, all your saints of God. Almighty and living God, you sent your only Son into the world to cast out the power of Satan, the spirit of evil, to rescue man from the kingdom of darkness, and bring him into the splendor of the kingdom of light. We pray for these children, set them free from original sin, take them to the temple of your glory, and send your Holy Spirit to dwell with them. We ask this through Christ our Lord. We anoint you with the oil of salvation in the name of Christ our Savior. We accept you with his power and love the name forever and ever. Oh, look at the fly right there in the middle of God. Right there. I got it. My dear brothers and sisters, we anoint you with the oil of salvation in the name of Christ our Savior. We strengthen you with the power and love the name forever and ever. Now we bless the water that we're going to use. Father, you give us grace through sacramental signs. You'll tell us of the wonders of your unseen power, the baptism with which you give the water, the which was made a rich symbol of the grace and diversity of the sacrament. But the very God of creation, the Spirit breathed under the waters, making them the wellspring of all holiness. The waters of the great flood were made a sign of the waters of baptism, making them the center of the new beginning of goodness. Through the waters of the Red Sea, we led Israel out of slavery to be an image of God's holy people, set free from sin by baptism. In the waters of the Jordan, your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Spirit. Your son willed that water and blood should flow from inside this wonderful cross. After his resurrection, he told his disciples, go out and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Father, look now with love upon your church, and unseal for her the fountain of baptism. As the power of the Spirit gives to the water of this font the grace of your Son. The created man in your own likeness, cleansing from sin and a new birth of innocence by the water of the Spirit. We ask you, Father, with your Son, to send the Holy Spirit upon the water of this font, that all who are buried with Christ will be left for baptism. Let us all too with them to newness of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Now we have the usual profession of faith. Dear parents and godparents, we come here to present these children for baptism, their water in the Holy Spirit, they are to receive the gift of new life from God as well. On your part, you must make it your constant care for faith. Come up in the practice of faith, see that the divine life which God gives them is kept safe from the flows of sin, grow always stronger in their hearts. If your faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, renew now the vows of your own baptism, reject sin, profess your faith in Christ Jesus. This is the faith of the church, and this is the faith in which these children are about to be baptized. You reject Satan, who will reject him, and all his works, and all his heavenly promises. You believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. You believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father. You believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. This is our faith, this is the faith of the Church. We are proud to confess it in Christ Jesus, our Lord. To the true well, the Jessica, the Kyle, to be baptized in the faith of the Church, which we have all confessed with you, and the faith of the Spirit. I think it'll make it easier for Jessica. God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has freed you from sin, given you a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit. We welcome you with these holy people, and we now anoint you with the prison of salvation, as Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so may you live always as a member of his body, sharing everlasting life. You see, that's one. That's one. That's one. Yeah, see, that's one. Good. Thus you can entirely become new creations and enclose yourself in Christ. See in these wayfarers the outward sign of your Christian dignity. With your family and friends who help you by word and example, bring that dignity unstained into the everlasting life of heaven. Now, there are all kinds of candles to hold for the photographer. Can you hold that one?
Steve blew it out.
Receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept and guided. These children have been enlightened by Christ. They are to walk always as a child of the light. May they keep the flame of faith alive in their hearts. When the Lord comes, may they go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. The Lord Jesus, who made the deaf hear, the dumb speak, may he soon touch your ears to receive his word. Conclusion of the rite. We have put on Christ in whom you have been baptized. Alleluia, alleluia. Dearly beloved, these children have been reborn in baptism. They are now called the children of God, for so indeed they are. In confirmation, they will receive the fullness of God's Spirit. In Holy Communion, they will share the banquet of Christ's sacrifice, calling God their Father in the midst of the Church. In the name of these children, in the spirit of our common sonship, let us pray together in the words our Lord has given us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. God the Father, through his Son, the Virgin Mary's child, who brought joy to all Christian mothers, as they see the hope of eternal life shine on their children. May he bless the mothers of these children. We now thank God for the gift of their children. May they be one with them and thinking and thanking him forever in heaven in Christ Jesus our Lord. And God is the giver of all life, human and divine, and bless the fathers of these children. They and their wives will be the first teachers of their children in the ways of faith, and we also be the best of teachers, bearing witness to the faith and what they say in you in Christ Jesus our Lord. By God's gift, through water and the Holy Spirit, we are reborn to everlasting life. In his goodness, may we continue to pour out his blessings upon these sons and daughters of his. May he make them always, wherever they may be, faithful members of his holy people. May he send his peace upon all who are gathered here in Christ Jesus our Lord. And may Almighty God the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless you. Amen. Now, if he's as handsome a boy as she is pretty. Yeah, right.
Thank you.
Today is what, the 24th?
Mm-hmm.
24th.
Yeah. 24th, day after Wild Man's birthday.
Warren, see, I got that mistake. October 27th. Oh, good. I've got an extra one here. Is that good? Good. Where's Cheryl from?
New Margaret.
Connecticut?
A little smaller, isn't it?
Did I get the right date to spell it?
Yeah.
Okay. Check it over, see if there's anything you want.
Thank you.
You did? Strange, John Strange. Well, he wanted to get his cemetery lot ready, you know, and Memorial Day. So at any rate, he got his tombstone up. We asked what he wanted on the tombstone. He said, just put two sentences. He was an attorney, and he was an honest man. So they said, yeah, but you're not putting your name on it. He said,
Everybody who go by and read that will say, that's strange. I can't believe this. I got through without a mistake. I can't believe this.
Good.
Yeah, she likes her tongue. The cold is getting
cold. No mistake.
Good. I'm the ultrasound one, too. Okay. And she has her.
Can we get a picture with all of us together? Or you got all that down?
Oh, it's all on.
Can we go down?
Yeah, that's right. You know, I didn't remember that.
Yeah, I do.
Are you ready?
I don't know what you're going to say.
Sing a song? Come on, everybody. Sing a song. I know, he's got a picture. You know, I maintain that the fellow who should take the picture should have a running commentary at his time.
Yeah. I usually commentary when I'm running it.
Say, look at over there, and this is guy is so-and-so, and that guy is so-and-so. He's the best picture. He even plays by the Lions Club. He should be.